back to my channel. If you guys are new, my name is Lorena Aguirre and I post here on my YouTube channel every Monday and Saturday. So if you like anything nails, make sure to subscribe and hit that button. And that bell button will notify you guys every time I post a new video. Alright guys, starting off, I am using Nailcentral's nail tips. These are amazing. I love them. His brand is so amazing. His brand is fairly new, so make sure to go check him out, show him some love, and tell him I sent you. But I am gluing them down. These are the tips that I am using. They're the square ones from his line. And then I am gluing them down with Montage's glue and this stuff. Honestly, you guys, if you are a beginner nail tech and you need some time kind of wiggling them around, this isn't the glue for you. But if you are somebody who is pretty advanced and wants them to hurry, stick them down and move on, definitely recommend this. I feel like you guys would definitely love this. It glues really, really fast, and you don't have to hold it for a super long time, which I love because we don't have time for that. We are in a rush. And so I'm going to go ahead and glue those down. I went ahead and got some Valentino. The nude that I am using, it is Glamorous Nude. And you guys, I was kind of hesitant on getting any more Valentino stuff just because of the videos that I've been seeing. But I was like, you know what? I want to be nosy. I want to know what's going on with it and if their colors are different. And that was my plan. But then after, I ended up getting a whole bunch of other colors that I didn't have. So basically, the only one that I have to compare to is one of them. So we will see if they are changing up the line and stuff like that. I didn't see anything on their page saying that the colors were going to be a little bit different or they're changing anything on them. So, so we will see if the one that I did get ends up being that way. But if I do, I will definitely post it on my TikTok. But yeah, so now I'm going to go ahead and cut these babies down to the length that I want. I want to do like a pretty long length, not super, super extra long, but long. So I'm going to go ahead and get my nail cutters. I got these nail cutters over at City Nail Supplies in Fontana. If you guys are in the California area, definitely make sure to check them out. They are a super sweet spot too. And then after, I went ahead and also got my brush cleaner. This brush was kind of being a pain in the butt. It kind of wanted to separate all funny and stuff. So I did end up having to change my brush that I was using, and I ended up picking out a different one, just because I didn't have time to kind of fiddle around with it and make sure that everything was like nice and perfect. So, but now I'm going to go ahead and blend my tips. The tips are what I'm using to blend it is a medium sanding band, just so that everything is nice and flush. I am not filing the natural nail. I am just blending it. And it's mostly the corners that I am blending because I don't want them poking up and out of the colored acrylic. But before this video, I have been doing a lot of pop-off sets, as you guys have seen in my previous videos, but just because I've been trying to do some nail content for you guys, and I want to be very gentle with my nails. So with that being said, I do have a peel-off base coat, but if you are somebody who's trying to content create, if you use the peel-off base coat, honestly, the peel-off base coat makes the nails pop off very easily. So that's why you see me kind of going in and out of the cameras, because they kept popping off throughout me working. And I wanted to try Mia Secrets monomer. So that is all I am doing. I've had this put away in the closet for some time now. And honestly, I just need to try it out and see. I see a lot of nail techs using it. They say they like it. And so I was like, you know what? Let's give it a go. I ended up just getting this at the nail lab when I was down in LA. And this was like a whole nother time. This was like a long time ago. But I did recently go to a nail spot. It's called Skyline Nails. And that is also in LA by the train tracks. So if you guys are looking for a nail supply in LA, definitely recommend checking them out. They have a lot of stuff. They have hair stuff too, if you are a hairstylist as well. I don't know if they carry a lot of lines as like for the hairstylist, but they did end up having some. But what I did want to mention is they had their showroom there, which I didn't know. Valentino's room, I'll go ahead and insert some pictures. But I didn't know that their showroom was in Skyline Nail Supplies, which I was super excited about just because that room looks so gorgeous. Honestly, pictures don't do it justice. But honestly, like, this room is pretty dope. I know that they do some of their classes here, are in that room and stuff like that. But honestly, like, I was super impressed. Like, the pictures did not do it justice. I wish I would have checked out more of the nail desk and stuff that they had there, because some of their nail desks they do have in that room all the way towards the back. And I was like, dang, I should have seen if I would have been interested in those types of desks for my nail room. But you guys, honestly, I feel like the room ended up being super, super cool, and just the vibe in there was really awesome. But I do want to mention that that's kind of why I feel like I ended up like kind of like wanting to shop in there, is because it looks so cute and I'm all for cute stuff. So I did end up getting new colors from Valentino. The colors that I got was Prettiest Pink. I restocked on Creme because that one was one that like my clients went through like crazy. And then Glamorous Nude. If you guys don't have Glamorous Nude from them, which this is the one that I am using in the video. But I do think something that I will try and get is the nude colors from their line, just because I do feel like they have a lot of different options. And I like to be able to share with you guys like some of the things that I have been getting. So honestly, with these, I feel like these would be great. And I don't know, all the colors, they end up like being super, super pretty. I mean, even if they do end up changing like the colors a little bit, I don't know, to me, like, I feel like that's not really as big of a deal. I think maybe if it was like a completely different color, then I would be like completely like unhappy and stuff. But I don't know, maybe it's just because I had like the colors that I did get, it didn't seem like far off or anything like that. So I don't know. So we will see. Only time can tell, especially once I'm going through these, then I'll be able to see like if what people are talking about is like a real thing, you know. So, because sometimes I do feel like people on the internet will, like, do things just for, kind of just for the attention and things like that, which, like, I don't know, I kind of just feel like, but in the comments it did seem like people, like, it was something that, like, other people had experienced. So, I mean, I guess we will see. I'll take whatever consequences end up happening if I do end up getting the whole line and it changes within a year. I mean, I feel like that would be a bummer, but I mean, by all means. But again, for this size of product, I believe it was like $15 for it. So honestly, I feel like even with inflation, I was kind of surprised that the price didn't end up going up on these, just because I feel like the price on everything has gone up tremendously. So that was something that I was actually surprised about. But I do notice when I go to LA, prices are a little bit cheaper than if I were to shop in my area. Like, I don't know if it's just because my area is like 2 hours away from LA or what. Or sometimes it'll be like an hour and a half or like something like that. Or like, I don't know. No, sometimes I think it's like 45 minutes. I think it just really depends on how traffic is. If traffic is bad, then you're looking at 2 hours. But honestly, you guys, I feel like it's, like, where I'm at is pretty far from LA, but I know, like, that's where all the ports are at. So before, I feel like it used to be a lot cheaper, and then to, like, before I used to go to Skyline, and I would get, like, files and buffers and stuff, each pack was, like, maybe $6 for the files for an 8080 grit. Now, their files ended up going up to, like, $25, $30 for some. I think theirs was, like, more $30. So I was like, you know what, let me try a different nail supply, like, closer to here. And I did end up finding one. I wish I could remember the name so I could refer you guys to there. But if you guys know, it's a pink building in LA, and she sells nail supplies there. And she has, like, Jellix and stuff there, too. But if you guys know the name, comment down below, because I'm sure there's only one pink nail supply down in LA. So if you guys by chance know what it is, please comment down below just to help everyone out. But her files and buffers, they were like a way better price than over there. I think I was able to get a pack for $15. But you guys, when being like super clean and sanitary with your clients, like honestly, I feel like it's like all going through buffers and files so fast. Like, I feel like all the time I just need to like go and repurchase, repurchase, repurchase. Like, I go through files and buffers all the time. And I know like some people will tell me like, well, why don't you just like reuse your buffers on that same client? Like, basically what they're saying is use the buffer, put it in a bag and wait for them to come back and use that same buffer that they used on them again. But honestly, I don't know. The thought of it, I don't like it. And on top of that, I don't have space to store all of these like files and buffers and stuff. So I think that's like kind of like what my deal is with that, is not being able to house all of that stuff. And it's like sometimes I have like returning clients, or a lot of my clients, they are returning clients, but then again, like I feel like it's like I do have some new ones here and there. So the only thing is like with that is just like, am I supposed to keep everyone's file and buffer? Like, I don't know, that's kind of a lot. So it's just like, and just to keep a file and a buffer in there, like, I don't know, to me it almost like kind of feels like it's like not really worth it. So I just feel like it's better just to completely throw them away and start over. I know it is costing me more, but at the end of the day, like, I don't know, in the state that I'm in, you're supposed to be throwing them away. You shouldn't even be housing them. So yeah, but I know like the reason why it is cheaper is because it's closer to the courts and things like that, or like that's basically what's been said, is they're able to get it cheaper there because they're closer to the courts. But I'm like, dang, like the markup on some of these things are just so crazy, like what has happened in the last year. So honestly, you guys, if you guys know where to get cheap buffers or files, definitely recommend commenting down below, just because files and buffers are getting crazy priced. And you know, I feel like with certain things, like I feel like things that aren't going to compromise your work, I feel like it's like you could get away with like kind of budgeting there. But certain things, like I don't know, with my product, I'm not really, I don't know, I feel like sometimes I'll try out stuff that's like cheaper, but only if it's like a hot item and I really feel like it will help me, and if I can't find it from any other brand that is like a reputable brand, then I will kind of go to Amazon and like search those things and try to find them. Like the when I got the Born Pretty, normally like I feel like something like that I would definitely try and find a brand that has those colors, and I'd much rather pay the extra money feeling and knowing that they're like a reputable brand rather than like one that is just like kind of off Amazon. Like, not talking, like I feel like it's like sometimes I feel like I'm like tiptoe around what I say because I don't want to offend anybody. I mean, if those are brands that you use, by all means, that's what you use, whatever. But I just feel like with me, like I don't like to offend anyone or anything like that. So it's like I don't want to ever come off the wrong way or like making it seem like I'm bashing anybody for what they're using. If that's what you could afford and that's what you want to use, then by all means, you are your own person. Do what you got to do to get your client's nails done. You know, but this is just speaking from like what I like, what I want, and things like that. So that is just something to kind of just a disclaimer, I guess. But now I'm gonna go ahead and go in with my gel polishes. Honestly, you could use any colors you want for this. I wanted to do something bright and poppy, so I did end up going with orange, like some like a really hot orangey red kind of color. And then after, I ended up going with an orange and then a yellow. I felt like these will all be really cute. I didn't want all the nails to be the same. I kind of wanted to like mix them up, so you guys will see that later on in the video. But I am doing some flames, and you guys could kind of see how I do them. I almost did like a Y kind of thing with some squiggly lines at the end. And now I'm going to go ahead and fill in and touch up certain areas that I need. I'm going to go ahead and let you guys watch me work. And if you guys have any questions or comments, make sure to comment them down below in the comment box, and I will get back to you if you guys need any help with anything. Thank you. Alright guys, now that I went ahead and cured that into the light for 60 seconds, I'm going to go ahead and get my detailer brush on the other end of this brush, and I am just going to go ahead and go in with any colors that I choose to highlight the flame and kind of give it that three-dimensional look.
Thank you.
right, now that I'm finishing up this one, I went ahead and put them into the light for 60 seconds. And now I am putting my matte top coat on it. The matte top coat I am using is Nail Essential. And you guys, if you guys are doing your own nails, I highly recommend having something to rest your hand on for filing, buffing, and just doing art if you need to, or even a top coat like this. I feel like using an acrylic powder like this helps me tremendously. And after I'm done with this, I'm going to go ahead and pop it into the light and cure it for 60 seconds. Alright you guys, this is the final look. I hope you guys really enjoyed today's video. If you guys haven't already, please don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe to the channel. And as always, I'll be back with more videos. Bye!